Okay, hello again. This was not what it was meant to be. Anyway, I'm Björn Faller.
And I'm Jean.
We went to meet in C++, what did you hear? And we thought we'd say a little bit about going there. So, meeting C++ is a big C++ conference in Berlin. It's been going on for some time. It's in November every year. It's in, what is it, sixth year in 2017. It's quite huge, four parallel tracks, three keynotes, one keynote every day, 3 days. You get people from pretty much everywhere in the world, although obviously most of them from within Europe, because it's what easier to travel there, but I met people from pretty much every part of the world. A lot of people, I'm not sure, I mean, more than 600. So, Will, you want to say something about it?
Yeah. So the event is very nice, it's very big, but it's also very pricey. So if you go there, I would recommend you to try to think about it as early as possible and try to get one of these early bird tickets that you will get in June or July, I think, that will save you 100 euros, so 1,000 kroner. If you're not super rich and you are students, I would recommend you to try to apply for the student free slots, where you will get the ticket for free, but you will still need to pay for the accommodation and the travel there. And what I would really recommend you is to try to be a volunteer, so you get the accommodation and food for free. And you will still need to pay for the travel, but most of the time, this is not what is the real cost to go in that kind of conference. The flight ticket might be much cheaper than the event itself. By being a volunteer, I guess you would also be a bit closer to the community, which is going to be a nice experience. Remember that if you're planning to book a room in the same location as the event, try to link them together to get a reduction. A lot of people forget about this every year, and it's kind of costly both for you and for the event organizer. So, why did we go there? Personally, I wanted to go to an IT conference for quite some time. And I wanted it to be a C++ one, for the first one, because I really like this language. And I've seen a lot of YouTube videos about these events. So, I kind of know what I would expect from there. And this year, there was a lot of speakers that I have already seen on YouTube videos. So I know that was a very good event. And what about you?
For me, it was my first visit to meeting C++, although I've been to a number of other conferences before, but I've heard good things about this conference. Like Jean, I've obviously watched YouTube videos and previous presentations. Also, there were a number of people I know since before who were going. Some as speakers, some as visitors. It's always nice to go and meet people. And that is actually a large part of the conference. So that is a big thing. When you have decided that you want to go, try to connect with people. If you're working for an international company, try to get in touch with colleagues from other parts of the world, see, but maybe they are going, maybe we could meet up there. Also, people you may not have met personally, but you know them from, say, this meetup, CTP Lang Slack, whatever. Get in touch, it's nice. For me personally, this was the morning going. little known thing, a hobby of mine is I brew beer. So I connected with a few people who I know were growing who had expressed an interest in beer and said, hey, I'm bringing a few bottles in case you want to try it. And that was a major success. The phone was pinging throughout the entire day, people leaving information about how their travel plans were unraveling, how things were going. And it turned out that Phil Nash, who's running the London Cyclocross Meetup and also is known for the catch unit testing framework, it turned out that his plane was arriving in Berlin roughly 15 minutes before mine. So we decided to travel together from the airport to the conference venue. Not much information on that one. Phil had, unlike me, done his homework, so he knew that there was a commuter train going from the airport, like 200 meters walk from the terminal, and cost 3 euros 50, so it's quite cheap. Stopped pretty much on the other side of the street from the hotel. So that was nice. Thanks, Phil. Appreciate it. And when I got there, I got this message from Pete Bindles, who I've never met before. I felt quite welcome, to be honest. So that was my getting to the event.
Yeah. So I arrived one day before the event, which was kind of nice because I could enjoy Berlin. The food is not that bad, and the price is very good. So yeah, I think it's kind of nice to be there a bit before. I had some issue with the application that I use at King to book things. This application wanted me to be as close as possible to your office in Berlin, and I'm a bit lazy, so I didn't want to fight against this application. So I took the first route it asked me to take, which was 25 minutes away from the location of the event. It's a bit annoying today when you have to travel there, wake up earlier. But it's also somewhat good because you kind of cut yourself from the events. And when you do full days of C++, at one point you really want to do something else because it's too much information. So, what I expected when I went to meeting C++ was to have some nice talk, but I was missing a huge part of the event, which is actually people, and people. If you want to watch nice talk, you can just go on YouTube, and you will be able to rewind, stop, have subtitles sometimes on your videos. So it might be actually even better to be at home to watch this kind of events. But you will really miss the people then. I've met a lot of legendary people, like Phil Nash from the District in Meetup, Vittorio Romeo, who has a nice blog, and a lot of people. And I also discovered that Björn was a rock star. So a lot of people came and just shake his hand and was like, okay, they are. And yeah, he could introduce me to these people. That was super nice. People is what you want to see at that kind of event. Not so much jokes.
Yeah, I agree, except for the rock star thing. But it helps if you, like I mentioned earlier, if you know people, even if you know them just briefly, it helps. People see your name tag and say, oh, okay, it's you, hello, nice to see you in the real world. I met some really interesting people there. I was super happy to meet Jonathan Bukara. I don't know if you read his blog, Fluent C++. If you don't, do start now, immediately. It's great. And we talked together a lot about type safety, brought in with Jonathan Miller also into that discussion. And we met with our peers from Gothenburg, Daniel Eriksson and Jakob Mossberg, who I haven't met before, I've just seen them on the Slack, actually. So that was nice. So yeah, the reason to go is not, as John mentioned, it's not to go to watch talks. You can watch them on YouTube. You go there to meet people. and you do meet a lot of people. Other than that, it's there are some fun things going on. That photo is from Conan J. Frog that had a C++ quiz. Quite bizarre. It's actually not very difficult to read that code if you change the emojis to words, but as it stands, it's absolutely hopeless. But it was fun, it was great fun. And talks differ a lot in difficulty. So there were definitely a lot of events that were beginners talks, and some were super advanced. You want to add something?
When you go to that kind of event, especially if it's the first one, you may feel that I will meet a lot of legendary people. They are all there, and they're going to judge me. They're going to point at my code and say, you are bad, and you should feel bad. That's not the case at all. You have a lot of beginner-friendly talks, so even if you are just starting in C++, this would be nice for you. And people are passionate. They are there to share their passion, not their hatred. Can you say that? Yeah. So, what I was saying that the talks are not what you should look for, I was a bit lying. Actually, there are some good talks there. I've particularly enjoyed two of them. The first one is from Klaus Gerberger.
Hopefully, Egelberger.
Egelberger, okay. And he was speaking about three new functions. So it's not about dictatorship where functions are unfree. It's about, how to say that? He's saying that maybe instead of using number functions, you should try to use free function first, and that might be a better idea. And he has a lot of arguments to explain why you should do that. So have a look at this talk if you can find it online. The second one was from Jonathan Okora, another French guy, who talked about strong types. So he explained that sometimes you want to take some basic types, like integer and boolean, and give them more semantic and more type safety. So that was the point of his talk. I think this one is already online and it's not looking so good. So due to some difficulties, technical difficulties. But Jonathan is a very good speaker, so if you can find some other talk online from that guy, just watch it. It's very nice.
Yeah, this was my absolute favorite talk of all I attended, and he showed not just how to use strong types to get to type safety, but how to make your code more expressive, to say more what do I want to happen, what I mean. So that was great, it's a little bit unfortunate that the recording that's out on YouTube is not the best quality, but it's well worth watching. And Kate Gregory, of course, obviously Kate Gregory, she's wonderful. She had a keynote with this title, It's Complicated. And what it's about is, well, C++, of course. It's about learning C++, learning the language rules. They're complicated. But also that as you strive to become a better developer, you should also strive to learn the lingo of the developers so that you know what people mean when they're talking about ODR violations, for example, or AII, obviously, spin-eyed away a function, what do you mean? Because when you know this language, it's so much easier to communicate with other developers. And when you know the language C++, and you know the language of C++ developers, you can write code that is not complicated, because you understand how things fit and you understand how to communicate with other developers, because you know the idioms that speaks to others. So that one is really good. It's a 2-hour talk. Watch it. And it's that recording is excellent. So there's no excuse. There's one more talk I would really like to promote, and that is a games developer, Guy Davidson, had a 10-minute lightning talk on the last day about diverseness and inclusion to build a better, more diverse workplace and be inclusive, be welcoming to other people. And looking at you right here, right now, it looks like it usually does at a C++ event. It's 90% straight white middle-aged males. That's a little bit of a problem, I think. His talk is really, really good about that. So watch it and try to learn from what he's saying and try to do your little thing to improve your workplace.
So if you want to watch the talk that we spoke about, you could go to one of these, the first link. And you can also find some trip records from people who have other selection of talk that they really like and with some summaries. So don't hesitate to go on this meeting C++ page. I think that's it for us. I really enjoyed that conference actually. It was very nice. Doing 8 hours of C++ per day is both enlightening but also exhausting. So maybe the next time we'll try to relax a bit more when we go there. Get some pause and reflect on what I've learned, not try to go to all the talks that I could go. If I can go next year, I would definitely give it a try. I would also try to go to CPPCon, which is the bigger conference in the United States. I think that's it more for me.
Yeah, I want to add also that I stayed at the conference hotel, and when I left on Saturday evening, I realized that was actually the first time I set foot outside the hotel since I arrived. Maybe it would have been a good idea to plan for some more time to actually see Berlin, be a little bit tourist. And also, I think it's not such a bad idea to, during the day, during the lunch breaks, so there's food everywhere all the time, so you're not starving for sure. But maybe collect a gang to go out and have dinner together somewhere else, just to not stay at the hotel the entire time. I think that is it. So, questions?
Is it in Berlin?
Is it always in Berlin? So far it has always been in Berlin. I have not heard about any plans to move it to any other city.
First year
was not in Berlin? Okay. I didn't know that. Anyone else?
Actually, not a question so much as a comment. Having watched Kate Gregory's talk, this is the best 2 hours we've spent on YouTube. So absolutely go watch it. It touches on inclusion, on better coding, on education, everything. So do watch it.
Yeah. What is that? Watch Kate Gregory's talk. Yes? Yeah, in my case we use Twitter a lot.
C++ conference has a picture.
There is a hashtag, yes, that is used a lot. Or in some cases, of course, direct messages if it's a specific person you want to get in contact with. Yes.
I think Slack as well is used.
Yeah.
There is an official, kind of official Slack server called CPP Long, I think. And there was a channel where it was about PC and C++. And a lot of people were very active during the event. So you could find them there. Other questions?
Okay, you mentioned CPPCon in the States. But do you think that is rather too much to bring in? Or you recommend this?
I've never been there.
No.
Yeah, I can't say, but I think how to say that? Maybe meeting CPPCon is a bit more prestigious, but somehow you will also miss very interesting people that won't be able to afford European people that won't be able to afford the travel to go to speak there. So it might be actually a good idea to go to meeting C++. The price is more or less the same. And the length of the event is a bit shorter for meeting C++.
Yeah, this year it was a little bit unfortunate that the conference happened to be on the same days as a standardization meeting. Otherwise, normally there are a number of people from the standardization committee at meeting C++. But this year, I don't think anyone from the standardization committee was there. They were all.
We had agreed with the committee.
So, more questions? Okay, thank you for your attention.